So welcome to the English class. So today we can start new chapter, the Pied Piper of Hamelin, page number 127. Okay, the Pied Piper of Hamelin. So Hamelin was a small town in Germany. The town was full of rats. They were in houses, inns, shops, schools, and in every street. Rats became a serious problem. Everyone wanted to find a solution for it. The mayor had often held meetings with the people of the town to discuss the problem. In the beginning, they thought the cats would drive away the rats, but it was very difficult to find a large number of cats. They were in a real dilemma. See, we can see what happened. So, Hamelin was a, there was a town. Small town, it was a small town. Where is it? In Germany. It was a small town in the Germany, and this place had was full of rats. This place had food was full of rats, and there were houses, inns, inns means lodges, hotels like that, shops, schools everywhere in every city. Because, but the rats became a serious problem because full of rats. Did there were full of rats, it was a serious problem for the people of the Hamelin. Everyone wanted to find a solution for it. So everyone wanted to find a solution to get rid of this rats. The mayor had often held meetings. The mayor of the Hamelin, no, held meetings in order to discuss the problem to get rid of this rats. But in the beginning they thought that the cats, you already know that cats kills rat, isn't it? But in the beginning they thought the cats would drive away the rats, but it was a very difficult the rats were huge in number, and it was a very difficult to get rid of this cats, and they were in real dilemma. Dilemma means in confusion. It was a hard situation. They were in confusion. It was a hard situation for them to get rid of this rats. Okay, one day, next paragraph. One day a stranger came to the town of Hamelin. He carried a pipe with him. He had a stern look and walked straight to the mayor's office. He faced the mayor of the Hamelin and said, "It's well known across Germany that Hamelin has a problem of rats. I will get rid of all rats. What would my reward be?" He asked. See, who walked away? One day, a stranger. A stranger came to the town of Hamelin, and he carried, what was in his hand? Pipe. He carried a pipe with him. He had a stern look. Stern look means serious look. He was not smiling. He had a serious look and walked straight to the mayor's office. Where did he go? He walked straight away to the mayor's office. He faced the mayor. He came in front of the mayor and asked him, what did he ask? It's well known. That is all. It's well known. Well known means already it is understood that many have been saying that there is a the Hamelin has a serious problem of rats. What did he say? I'll get rid of. He said that I'll help you to get rid of these rats. What will you pay for me? What would be my reward? He asked to the mayor. For a moment, the mayor was stunned. What happened? Hearing this, the mayor was stunned. Stunned means surprised. He was very much surprised. Why? Because it was very difficult task, isn't it, to get rid of the huge number of the rats. Then this stranger told that he will do that. This mayor was stunned, surprised. It was difficult for him to believe that a single man could do it. It was very difficult. It was very difficult for him to believe this single man will do this job. 10,000 gold coins from our treasure. If you can, do as you promise, said the mayor. The stranger nodded his head and said, In a day's time, Hamelin will have no rats. The stranger walked out in the street, pulled out his pipe and started playing it. An eerie sound floated in the air. People of Hamelin could hear the beautiful tune from every corner of the Hamelin and were paralyzed by the enchanting music. So when the mayor offered him 10,000 gold coins, what did the stranger do? He nodded. What that means? He shook his head and said, in one day, within one day, within one day, I will get rid of all these rats, said the stranger. And what did he do? He walked towards the street and put his pipe and started playing it. I already told you, the pipe was there in his hand and he started to play with this pipe. A eerie sound. Eerie sound means frightening sound. Very frightening, strange and frightening sound floated in the air. Floated in the air. The people of Hamelin could hear the beautiful tune. The people, what did they hear? They heard the beautiful tune from every corner of the Hamelin. Were paralyzed from every corner of the Hamelin. Okay, and the people of the Hamelin were paralyzed. Paralyzed means they were not able to move. Okay, they were not able to move. They were standing stunned. They were not able to move. Paralyzed means not able to move by the enchanting music. Enchanting music is pleasant, very sweet music from the sweet music. Okay, next page. Take next page, page number 127. We can continue. Yes. All of a sudden, there was a whirring noise. Thousands of the rats came all the way from various directions. They followed the piper. It seemed that the rats were mesmerized by the delightful music of the pipe. The stranger headed towards the sea with all the rats of the Hamelin behind him. It was an extraordinary sight for the fox of Hamelin. So what did the stranger do? Stranger was playing the rats, and what happened? All of a sudden there was a whirring sound. Some strange sound, and thousands of, what was the sound? That was the sound of the rats was coming away from various directions. Rats was hearing this music and followed the pied piper. They were mesmerized means what? They were attracted. They were their attention was changed to the direction of the music they were hearing, and they followed the pied piper. Okay, the stranger headed towards the sea. What did the pied piper do? He walked towards the sea, and what happened? Rats also followed him. It was an extraordinary sight for the fox of Hamelin. Fox means people of Hamelin. The stranger played the pipe continuously. What did the stranger do? He began to play his pipe continuously and walked right into the sea. The rats followed him in large numbers. All of them were caught by the waves, which dragged them into the sea. All the rats of the Hamelin were drowned. The strange piper thus got rid of all the rats. He kept his word. So all the rats followed him. When he what did the stranger do? He stranger played his pipe and walked towards the sea. Then the rats also followed him, and all these rats were dragged by the waves, were washed away by the waves of the into the sea. They were washed away by, they were caught by the waves and dragged into the sea, and all the rats of the Hamelin were drowned. So he, what did the stranger do? Pied Piper, he kept his word. Kept his word means, what was his word? He'll get rid of the rat within one day. So he kept his word. The stranger approached the mayor for his reward. After that, what did he do? He approached the mayor for his reward. Okay, for his reward. What was the reward? 1,000. How much was the reward offered to him? 10,000 gold coins, isn't it? Yes. And he asked for his reward. Okay, the mayor of the town, people, stranger approached the mayor for his reward. The mayor and the townspeople enjoyed watching and the bizarre sight. But the mayor had changed his mind. After that, what happened? But the mayor already offered him 10,000 gold coins. Now what happened to the mayor's mind? He changed his mind. When the stranger asked for this reward, what did he do? It's a wonderful task you have accomplished. Now what did the mayor say? It's a wonderful, what you have done is very good job. But is this, next page, isn't this 10,000 gold coins a hefty reward for the day's work? What did he say? But this 10,000 gold coins is too much. Very much, no? Asked the mayor to the pied piper. I'll pay you 500 gold coins. What did the mayor say? Instead of 10,000, I'll pay you 500. That stranger looked at the mayor and then walked out. What did the stranger do? He did not speak anything. He looked at the mayor and walked away. Okay. walked away. He did not speak anything. In the street, he pulled out his phone. What did he do? He began to play his pipe again. Okay, this time in a different sound. It was not the pleasant music. It was another sound. Okay, but eerie as well. Eerie means the strange and frightening sound. Okay, the sound was very strange and frightening. All the children of hearing this music, who came? All the children of Hamlin started to follow the stranger. They started to follow the stranger. All the children. Children of the Hamlin. He walked off the town and disappeared into the mountains. What did he do? He walked playing his pipe. He walked and the children followed him and he was disappeared into the mountains. The children followed him. Okay, the children also followed and he disappeared. The parents wept. Wept means began to cry. When the stranger took their children, the parents began to cry. They complained to the mayor. What did they do? They complained to the mayor, but he was helpless. But the mayor was helpless. He felt guilty. He felt guilty that he had been dishonest to the stranger. Guilty means he felt bad. Why? Because he offered 10,000 gold coins, but he refused to pay. And he felt sorry to himself for what he had done. That is a story. I think students, you have understood this. So, read this lesson. And the homework is page number 126. No? One notice. Prepare a notice. That write it and submit. Okay. Thank you. We can stop here. Thank you.